Good afternoon. I'm Tonya Arnesen, Senior Pastor of Jackson First United Methodist Church, and this is Food for Thought for Friday, January the 22nd, 2021. It is a cold and gray day outside, and I reflect on seasons of life as I'm doing this sermon series on the seasons of life. It occurred to me this week that regardless of what season we're in, I oftentimes find myself longing for a different season. While I enjoy the snowy beauty of a crisp wintry day, by this time in January, I am tired of slush and cold and gray. I begin daydreaming about sunshine and the warmth of summer. And I love summertime with its lush green growth and time away from the typical demands of church life. But I don't love the endless hot human days of late July and August, which wilt body and spirit. During those dog days, I find myself longing for sweater weather, when it's cool enough to walk the dog and kick through a blanket of red and green and orange leaves. But when the trees are stark and bare and everything's fallen off and we're experiencing endless days of cold Michigan drizzle, my heart longs for spring, when I know the earth once again will teem with new life and hope. I love all the seasons, and it seems I'm never completely content with the season we're in. To be sure, there are gifts and challenges in every season of life. And if our congregation, First Church, United Methodist Church in Jackson, is going to live fully into our vision to be an inclusive, intergenerational community of faith, then we will be intentional about embracing every season of life, finding value and showing respect and appreciation for whatever season folk are in. This past Sunday morning, we heard from Ellen and Barry Keatley about the gifts and the advantages of being in the winter season of life. But they were also very honest about the inevitable losses and changes that are foisted upon us as we age. This Sunday morning, we're going to hear from Tori and Mike Munier, from Sadie Fisher and Jack Reynolds, who are youth. They're going to talk about what it means to be in the spring season of life. And as I looked at the manuscript of their presentation, it occurred to me that I would have expected nothing but flowers and excitement and hope. And yet they recall for me that this is a very difficult season of life for them as they're faced with all kinds of decisions about what their future is going to bring. This Sunday, I'm going to be preaching from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 13. It's a well-known story or parable called the parable of the sower, but I'm going to offer a different take on this parable. I hope you'll be with us this Sunday, either live in our sanctuary at 10:30 or by live streaming at 10:30, or if you are coming to us after 10:30 on Sunday, you can watch us on YouTube or on cable television on Monday at 7 p.m. However you join us, I hope that you will be blessed by our worship service this week. In the meantime, be blessed and continue to be well, and know today that you are a beloved child of God. Amen.